It's Mason.
Last night you hung up on me. You said you'd call me back, but you didn't. I expect an apology, Mason.
Yeah, well, I apologize about that, Miss Aaron, but if you only knew what ended up happening.
Oh, really? So tell me what happened.
You okay?
I'm fine, don't worry. Well, I'm stranded in the middle of nowhere, that's all.
Did the car break down again?
Sort of.
Two flat tires in the front.
Ugh. Okay, well, tell me where you are and
I'll arrange for a driver to get you.
Oh, really?
That'd be great.
Okay, tell me where you are and I'll organize something for you.
Where am I? Oh, I'm off of West Putnam Avenue near Pemberwick Park. There's a place called Alden Road. That's just to the west of Weaver Street.
You find the car?
Yeah, but there's a man here. He's looking inside the car while talking on the phone.
Is it the doctor, Robert?
No, not the doctor. I don't know who it is.
Oh, wait, man. Do you think it's
the guy Ethan mentioned? The one who was following him before?
It could be.
What should I do?
What do you think you should do? Sort it out, man.
Understood.
It'll probably take a few hours considering I'm out in the woods. So tell me, why are you in such a hurry to see me anyway, Miss Aaron?
Do you miss me?
It's not like that, silly.
There's something that I need to tell you.
Yeah? Why? Is something wrong?
Gerald got a message from the kidnappers. They said Kareem's life depended on him.
What? But when? What time was that? Miss Aaron, why didn't you tell me before?
It was last night.
I was going to tell you all this last night, but you wouldn't let me speak. You hung up on me, if you recall.
Listen, Mr. Mason, we really need to be in constant contact with you. We lost contact with you last night.
Besides, Layla seems to calm down when she hears your voice. Imagine that.
But don't let that
go to your head, though. It just means that you're useful for a change.
I'm not sure how many more times I'm willing to face certain debt so I can prove my worth to you. Ugh.
Mr. Mason? Hello? Mr. Mason? If Layla asks about me, tell her I had to go out and I'll be back soon.
Mother. She thinks she's the lady of the house now?
Kenny.
Hmm?
Something isn't quite right today, my son. Your father should have contacted us by now, no matter what, my son. I asked Mr. Gerald, but he wouldn't say anything.
It must be something serious, then. I wonder if he's up to something, Mother. I don't know. Now that I think of it, he said something like that to me.
What did he say?
He said that we were gonna be rich. Maybe he didn't mean with the horses.
Oh, Kenny, do you think we should go to
the
police?
No, I'm not the police. We shouldn't get them involved. Let's not get him into trouble. Let's wait a little bit.
Can you ask Mr. Gerald one more time for me? Please, my darling. He already snapped at me.